Nothing like pyrotechnics, you name it. This crowd is ready. To about the 29, just shy of the 30. Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down. Second and 6, just inside the 30. They fake the give. Now wins. And complete to Zach Ertz. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. In territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 46. They run with Ajayi. As he's got this down inside the 40 to the 39. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and 3.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice solid gain. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there.
Here's Ajayi. Now he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. It'll be a loss of a full 3 yards there, and it also brings up third down.
All right, quick observation, Brandon, because early on in this game, I'm seeing linebackers playing with their noses close to the line of scrimmage.
And my guess is the wheels are turning on that other sideline. As a play caller, you're filing that away right now, aren't you?
Yeah, you're trying to find that opportunity later on when you can play action them or stick something to them between the second and the third level.
And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36. It's the first time that they've looked his way tonight, and he comes up with a first down on the play. So from the 36 now, first and 10.
We got three.
On first and 10, here's Wentz. Ertz over the middle. And all the way inside the 15 before they drop him. 23 yards on the play.
Brandon, lest my eyes deceive me, I think they found a matchup that they're trying to exploit here, don't you? I mean, that's the second time they've gone to him here on this drive.
Yeah, opening drive. It's a tone setter, right? I think they're going to be looking his way a lot.
Yeah, and I think that the way things are going right now, they like him as a featured receiver. Let's see what kind of adjustments the defense is going to make to try and take that away.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Again, it's Wentz. Dancing to his left. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. All that gets him is just a yard, and now it's third down. Eighth play of this opening drive coming up. This is third down. Shotgun now for Wentz. Flushed out right. And that is caught. It's Aguilar for the Eagle touchdown. Nelson Aguilar, his fourth touchdown on the year. And the Eagles drive right down the field and score on the opening drive. Elliott Good with a PAT. Elliott now to kick this one away. This is taken at the 3. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. Play fake here on first down. Flush to his right. Oh, he's going to air it out right away. So they took a shot on first down, but couldn't connect.
Defensively here, you're facing a top five team in terms of points scored in the NFL. So when they're that high powered, you've got to find a way to hold them under 20. Because to me, that's the magic number. 20 points scored, give yourself your best chance to win.
So if they're up around 24, 28, 30, they could be in some trouble.
I think so, because then you turn into a shootout, and that means your offense has to keep pace.
Ball on the 30 as they come up second and 10. Second and 10, Luck again. Got his man complete over the middle. That's Richardson. And he's taken down right at the 45-yard line. A good pickup there, 26 yards. So from Philadelphia territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 45-yard line. Now a play fake and it's Luck. And that is incomplete.
Well, that certainly looked like something that they discussed all week in practice getting ready for this one. Take the big shot right out of the gate. At worst, you'll open up the defense a little bit, loosen them up, have them back on their heels.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Again, Luck. Over the middle, complete. That's Richardson. And he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field. So a decent game, but all for naught on the penalty.
It's too bad, isn't it? They were feeling pretty good about it. Only people celebrating, the guys who just gave up that play.
6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's second and 4. Throwing again is Luck. And he finds a man with a crossing route. It'll go as a gain of 6 that time, and it moves the chains as well.
Charles, Thursday night game, I think a lot of teams probably say shrink the playbook somewhat. Is that correct?
I think you're right about that, because you just don't have the amount of time that you have in a normal week to put in a full playbook. So, as you said, you shrink the playbook, pick out the plays that work best for you. You know what else you're looking for?
What's that?
Who are the freshest guys coming off of the last game to play on a Thursday night? Guys have a little extra pep in their step. You go to them early and often.
9 yards is the pickup there, and they'll have a second and 1. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll be brought down inside the 20 at the 19. At 5 yards on the play there, as the drive will continue. He was well over 100 yards last week. He told us this week, a little ambitious, said he wants to hit that 200 mark. We'll see.
Makes sense, though, doesn't it? Have we ever run into a running back that had a great game the week before that didn't think that's just going to naturally continue, just make sure you feed me the football? And that's what they're all about. Continuity, rhythm, number of carries. Just keep giving it to him.
It's a nice pickup of 12 yards, and it gives him a first and goal. You were telling me this yesterday. This is exactly what they want to do on the opening drive, establish the ground game.
Yeah, remember our conversation. We were talking about what one of the GMs in the league has told me repeatedly. It's a big man's game, and it's not necessarily size. He's talking about playing some big boy football. Line up, get leverage, knock people back, and establish the run early.
And a little bit of space there takes it inside the 5 to the 3. Give him 4 yards there on the first down keeper.
But that call makes sense, because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. Then they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
So the ball position now at the 3. Here's second and goal. Now Luck. And he's got his man. That's Crowder for the Redskins touchdown. Jamison Crowder, his 5th touchdown now on the year. And the Redskins are an extra point away. So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Here comes Eagle offense now as they get set to take over here.
And they had to wait a long time to get the football back. Probably not what you were hoping for when you got an offense that's humming.
Agreed. What you were looking for is the defense getting the ball back pretty quickly, right? Hoping for a 3 and out. So that didn't happen. You can't yell at your D for that. They've got to take care of their own business and reestablish themselves now that they're back on the field.
Now Wins. And that's incomplete. Before the game, they were running the route tree about as efficiently and effectively as we could have possibly imagined, but sometimes the passes just go awry.
Yeah, let's face it. When you're running the route tree in pregame, you don't have defenders breathing down your neck. You don't have defensive backs making plays on the football. Hard to replicate the intensity of the game in pregame.
Wentz will try again on second down. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
So it can't hang on. And as I watch that unfold, I remembered an expression that I've heard, maybe from you, I don't know. But you're going to get hit anyways. Might as well hold on to the ball.
Well, you know a coach said that, right?
Yeah.
Not an actual player. Not a chance at all. Way easier said than done.
Now Wentz on third down. He'll have a first down past the 40 and all the way up to the 46. The 21 yards there as they convert on third.
It's a nice job hitting him on the angle route there. Come out of the backfield, cutting sharply across the middle. And that's good timing between the quarterback and his receiver.
Effective third down play to move the chains. On the bootleg. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
The beauty of being able to play a zone defense, when you can sit back and see the ball coming out of the quarterback's hands, guess what? Creates a lot of confusion. Kind of a muddle in the middle of the field where you can go make a play on the football.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Wins to throw again. Steps away to his left. Looking left side. He's got it complete. And he'll get it down to the 47 here. Give him 7 on the play. And they're going to face a third down.
He was out there waving his arms. And when you got a quarterback out of the pocket looking for any help, I guess waving the arms is helpful.
It certainly is, because you got to get his attention. Because now you're in scramble drill. So everyone's adjusting their routes, finding open space. And he found the right spot for the completion.
Wentz going to try and throw on third. And he connects with Ertz. And he's got this down to the 35. An Eagle first down there. Wentz to Ertz. And the names that end in TZ.
I got a kick out of that one, partner. You and I talk often about trying to hide receivers in certain situations. But a guy of his size can't really hide him. But the tight end drag route, definitely an effective way to sneak him across the formation for an easy completion and a first down.
Now it's a Johnny, and that play went nowhere. Losing yardage, it'll be back at the 36. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Come on now, come on now, let's go.
This is a Johnny, and able to push his way forward here for a good little game. 4 yards on the pickup there as they get it back to a more manageable 3rd and 7.
One thing to keep in mind, partner, especially in the second half, when you've got a running back of this size, of these dimensions, I can just tell you, attrition does set in for a defense, because you're excited about hitting him in the first half, maybe not so much in the second half, and some of these shorter gains turn into bigger runs later.
And Jeffrey's got it, and he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line. The first catch for Jeffrey. Good enough for a first down. Clock running, under 4 to play now as they come up on 1st and 10. From the gun, it's Wentz. Buying time to his left.
he's to the 10. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down. So the youngster able to use the legs to pick up the first.
And one of my pet peeves when they see this guy play, when Carson Wentz takes off running the football, I always hear people go, oh, he's sneaky athletic. No, he's athletic. Watch him do it. It's an integral part of the quarterback run game, and he gets it done very, very well.
You don't like sneaky athletic, do you? That's kind of a jab in the back.
Yeah, not when it doesn't apply. I think that's a stereotype that needs to be broken down for him.
Be interesting to see now what they do offensively down near the goal line after not much there that time.
As the offensive play caller, that may change your sequence now. Instead of coming right back with a running play, you may have to go to the air.
Wentz to throw on second down, eluding the pressure right. This is taken in by Jeffrey. He's got it. Touchdown, Eagles. Carson Wentz with two first-half touchdown passes. And the Eagles are able to cash it in for six. It took them an extra look, but they found that point. And that makes the score 14-7. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Out comes the Redskin offense now as they get set to begin another possession. And that last drive was very, very balanced, pretty methodical. You think they go that route again?
I'm always of the school that until they stop me from doing something, I'm willing to continue. And I think that that's exactly what they'll look to do. But the beauty is the balance that they've created sets up opportunities for big plays. Looks like a run, turn into a play action, and throw one deep.
Here's second and seven now from the 28. Play action, it's locked. Sliding out of the pocket. Now he's going to throw deep right. He's got a man complete. And he finally goes down at the 23-yard line. A huge play there for Washington. 49 yards. So the big play gets him all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone here for first and 10. Luck on first down. And he drops this off to Thompson, complete. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. Two minutes remain here in the first half. Back to FedEx Field following this short break. But the Redskins look to get this one back, and indeed they did. It's still Washington football. They'll grab 3 yards on the play, taking it himself for the first down. A chance now to get even before the break as they come up first and goal. Now they'll run it on the toss. And this play doesn't go anywhere. Backwards, losing yardage to the 11. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. So they get pushed back to the 11, and here's second and goal. A shotgun snap for Luck. Lost the football. It's out. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
When I see a play like that, I come back to risk reward. I don't know about you, but is it worth it at that point, whatever you're going to pick up, to either take the hit, and in this case, lose the football.
No, should have gone down. I mean, hindsight's always 20-20, but that's the safe play.
You're exactly right. Hindsight's really never wrong, is it? Because you can analyze it, but I think ultimately you got to look at it as a first option, taking care of the ball, getting what you can, and that's it. Don't worry about it anymore.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. And they'll try the ground game here with the running back. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. That one good for 10 yards. And they'll be faced with a third and inches. They'll run it now out of the gun. And not only will he not get the few inches he needs, he's going to go backwards. Here now, Johnny Townsend, as his first punt will come from inside his own end zone. And this is away. It's a high kick, and he got all of it. This is taken at the 18. A very good return there. Give him an even 20 yards. And it'll be Redskins football now with a first and 10. A look at Washington as they come onto the field. And they'll be looking to atone for last time's mistake of fumbling inside the red zone. Certainly they don't want to do that again.
And so much emphasis placed on red zone offense. I mean, you have periods devoted in practice just for that because everyone knows how vital it is to put points on the board when you've entered that part of the field. And to come away with nothing, that's difficult for a team to handle.
And difficult, and now we'll see if they can make it less difficult on themselves on this drive. They work again from the 38 on second and 10. Back to the air, Luck on second down. Being chased out left. Incomplete.
It's been my observation, there's been a nice variety of play calling defensively. You and I often talk about an offense's ability to keep a defense off balance with what they're doing. I think the converse has been true in this game.
Yeah, I think you're right. They seem to have gone off tendency quite a bit, but only the second quarter, a lot of time to change things. Throwing on third down, Luck. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
Not only was the call spot on, how about the execution of that defense right there? The zone was absolutely locked up tight. He was trying to force it in there on third down.
But if there's a time to force it, he felt like he needed to make a play, right?
Yeah, exactly right. Third down, you got to try and find something. There's nothing available there for him.
And out now come the Eagles. They're going to have to go at least 50, 60 yards here if they want to ensure that they don't have to punt the ball like they did last time.
Yeah, so what you're saying is we're not playing to just get out a shot of your own goal line, right? You're playing to make sure the punter doesn't see the field again. So it's not picking up a couple of first downs. You want to pick up five or six first downs and make sure you move the ball into their territory.
Just 11 seconds to go in the half as they have it first and 10. And with time running down, they go down to a knee. So we've reached halftime here, and it's our visitors, the Eagles, leading this one. As we'll get you down the coast to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach! Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. This is taken at his four. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. Out comes Washington's offense as they get set to take over here. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason you're down. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half, and we've got the football. Let's go ahead and punch it in, and then we'll take it from there.
See how that recipe works.
Right back to him on first down. And the play goes nowhere. Losing yardage back near the 40 at the 39. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down. Here's Luck now on second down. And an alley to run. And able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. Luck showing he can be dangerous when he tucks and runs. He's able to pick up the first down. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. On first and 10, Luck. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. A good first down call as the screen play gets him 9.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass, looked like it was coming together, looked like there was an opening. Still, ended up with a solid game.
On second down, here's Long. They'll drop it off to Piron, complete. He goes for 18 there as the drive will continue.
We can talk all we want about football being a game of backfield to make a bigger play.
As we often say, get it to him in space, let him use his leg.
Yeah, if he can get a matchup against a linebacker or maybe a defensive end dropping out in a zone blitz, he's going to win that battle just about every time.
And he'll be brought down. Oh, that's a face mask. Certainly looked like it. Indeed, here come the flags. Well, we looked at each other right away. We knew that flag was coming out.
And I always enjoy the conversation post. Because officials always tell you, I don't want to throw the flag, but you caused the play. You did it. I had to.
Now Piron, and he'll be stopped up after only a couple of yards as he gets it down to the 5. Defensively, pretty good start there with their backs against the wall.
That's a win for the stop troops right there. And if I'm them, I get a little bolder now. They won the first battle. Keep coming after them. Put the pressure on them.
And the ball smack dab on the 5-yard line. Here's second and goal. Luck now to throw. Forced out to his left. Able to get away. And this will be incomplete.
They certainly thought they had him surrounded and probably thought they were going to get him on the ground and get the sack, but he was able to elude that. And even though it threw it incomplete downfield, if you're a defensive back, you're loving the pressure that you're seeing from your front.
They come up now 3rd and 5 following the incomplete pass. From the gun, here's Love. And that is caught. Touchdown, Washington. Jeremy Sprinkle, his first touchdown on the year. And the Redskins are an extra point away from tying this thing up. Here's Hopkins now for the extra point. Extra point good by Hopkins. And we are tied all even as the kick's away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. So here are the Eagles now as they get set for their first possession of the second half. First half showed us some pretty good offense. Tie game, we'll see what the second half brings.
And it'll be interesting because I think both sides feel pretty good about what their offenses are doing. Gotta wonder what adjustments are being made defensively to try and get a spark and maybe slow down the other side.
But here, do you change up anything on this opening drive?
Not offensively, you don't. You've got everything going your way. You've probably prepared for maybe some change-ups you might expect, but overall, you like what your game plan's showing you.
2nd and 6, just inside the 30. Now Wentz throwing on 2nd down. Hurts over the middle. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. An Eagle 1st down, Wentz to Ertz.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
Wentz now to throw. And that's complete to Jeffrey. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. A very solid gain of 27.
Quarterbacks love slant routes because the receivers are breaking right into their line of vision. And receivers love them as well because they're getting the ball on the move and able to catch it and try and get upfield and gain additional yardage.
And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 37-yard line. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
I like the idea to mix it up from time to time because, let's face it, you can't be predictable. But the execution was a little lacking on this one, right? They might want to go back to the drawing board with that call.
On second down, here's Wentz. Escapes the sack. And now he'll tuck it and run. He'll wind up with positive yardage. It's a gain of 3, but now it's third down.
How about a tip of the cap to the defense? They're working against a very mobile quarterback, but all day long they've kept him under wraps. And on that play, they held him to a short gain.
Here's Wentz to throw. Ertz has it left side. And he's going to be out down inside the 20 at the 15. His 5th catch tonight, and it's good for a first down. This drive, it's been a good mix. 3 passing plays, 3 runs, hitting on all 3 of those passes, and the last one putting him in the red zone.
So wouldn't you think play action right here? Because you've got the ability and had the ability to run it and throw it. Go play action and take your shot at the end zone.
Now they'll run it on the toss. And they'll lose yardage here. Knocked back to the 19-yard line. It's a loss of 4 there, bringing up second down.
I know the scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker. And what that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play.
Shotgun now for Wentz. Escaping the pressure right. And he'll be forced out of bounds shy of the line of scrimmage, so that'll be credited as a sack. That'll be a loss of a yard, and it leads to a third down. Back-to-back running plays putting him in negative territory. What can they do coming up on 3rd and 15? Wentz. He'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. Good contain. No gain on the screen, and it'll bring up 4th down.
I know you've got a baseball background, right?
A little bit. Started in minor league ball.
Yeah, you did some of that, right? What do they do when they do the signals? An indicator, right?
It goes or not, yeah.
Yeah, whether the play's on or not. How about the indicators offensive linemen give when they're getting ready to run a screen pass? And if those get red, well, we just saw that there, didn't we?
No gain.
No gain. Deciphered it and finished the play off.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. Right off the bat, it's a first down to start the drive, 12 yards.
All right, it's football 101 to know that the quarterback controls just about everything on offense, but a lot of times what gets missed is that the center controls line play. He has to communicate to the guards and the tackles what type of front they're facing, how they're going to block it, and what adjustments need to be made sometimes on the fly as a defensive shift. Give the center a lot of credit.
Eagle pressure, too much this time. Down he goes. Timmy Jernigan able to get in there and take him down for a loss of 3. Back now at FedEx Field. All even as we get ready to start the 4th. So following the sack, they'll try to change their fortune here on 2nd and 13. Now a play fake and it's locked. And it's incomplete.
Oh, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing. Just chucked it free.
Yeah, live to fight another down, right?
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down.
Hey, easy. Go!
Out of the gun, Luck. Going to throw right side here, complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. That catch puts him over 70 yards receiving now as he's got a first down. Both teams working on short rest, but this has been one of the better Thursday night games we've seen as they come up here on first and 10. Now they'll run it on the toss. Avoids him at the 40. Once more the juke. 20! And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. That one good for 33 and a first.
Another carry for their leader and a good one. It's crunch time. They'll need him to continue to be productive in both the run and passing game in order for them to try and snatch a victory.
So how about this for field position after the big play? Inside the 15 now as they come up on first and 10. Running game working. They'll stick with it on first down. And this time they were ready for him as he... To throw on second down is Luck. And this is caught. I think he got that with one hand. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. Give him 9 yards on the second down screen play.
What a catch and one-handed. And I'm starting to lose my awe about the play. And maybe I shouldn't. How much of this is the player? How much of it is the glove?
Well, those gloves... they do have a little grip to them.
They get that little extra tackiness.
And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Redskins. It's the fullback. His second touchdown on the season. And the Redskins are going to take the lead. Hopkins with the extra point. And the lead is now 21-14. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. This one fielded at the 5. And he's going to take this all the way down inside the 40.
And when you're facing a deficit on the scoreboard, you're just looking for something to get you right back into the game. And that's the spark that they were looking for. They got it with that big return.
Now a play fake here on first down. He finds Aguilar over the middle. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. 23 yards on the play. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as...
looking for Aguilar, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Kayvon Webster. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
As much football as we watch, we've seen this work many times. In the red zone, first down, take a shot at the end zone, and points result. In this case, though, give credit to the defense. They outguessed them, were prepared, and intercepted the pass.
They run it here with Thompson. And he'll be hit and dropped for a loss at the 5-yard line. Charles, you'd said the magic number was probably right around 20 for this defense because they're facing one of the top 5 offenses in the league in terms of points scored. They've had their moments, but this offense, just a little too good, isn't it?
They really are, because no matter what you do to make an adjustment on defense, they've had an answer for it.
On the ground, it's Thompson. And a nice pickup as this one gets him to the 10-yard line. Rasul Douglas there to get him down. A tight game like this, such a tough spot for the offense to be in, even though they have the lead, Charles, back up so close to their goal line, they got to protect the football.
And that's when you have to take care of your team with play calling as well. Not a lot of misdirection, not a lot of counters, not a lot of plays where you have extra ball handling. Get it right to the hands of your running back, tell him to take care of the ball, and try and move forward.
Now it's Long, going for the deep ball. Oh, incomplete. Nearly the pick they needed. They would have loved one there, but at least it does get them to fourth down.
I think he's taking an awful chance with the football right there. You've got to lead. You've got to protect it. And he's taking chances putting it out there in a little bit of jeopardy.
Especially in a spot like this, fourth quarter, as you said, trying to cling to that advantage.
Yeah, that one probably should have been picked, huh?
Well, he wasn't too far from breaking that officially. Give him 15, and the Eagles will have it, taking over first and 10. The Eagles offense now, they head back on the field, and the interception thrown in the red zone last time. We'll see if they can rebound.
I just have to think the last thing he said as they went back out there was, don't do that again. What do you think?
What do you think?
Yeah, I think that. I think that not only did he say that, but he also told him, let's put it in the end zone that it's supposed to be in, all right? The end zone we're trying to score. I know we're being a little bit facetious here, but the bottom line is take care of the football, and everything else should flow from there.
Quick lesson, never ask the play-by-play guy a question.
Hey, you're my partner. I know you're right there with me.
Wentz going to throw. Pressure, and he's going to be taken down. They sack him back right around the 44. Joey Bosa in there to get him for sack number 9 now on the year. Eagles coming up here on a 3rd and long, so Wentz and company with some work to do after the sack. Working from the gun, Wentz. He'll rifle this one deep right. And oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off by Kayvon Webster. Oh, now he bowls him over. And the return this time will go out to the 42-yard line. Now, Green, that's twice now in this fourth quarter.
As a quarterback, a lot of times you think it's all on you to make plays when you're losing. And here, the play's not there, but he throws it anyway.
A good starting spot for the Redskins as they come up first and 10. Now Thompson. And very little daylight there. He'll get a couple up to the 44. Time for a break. We'll come back, see what transpires after this. This, in all probability, another run here on 2nd and 8. Again, a run with Thompson. And he's going to be taken down with a marker on the field. So let's see about the call. That hold coming from the middle of the line, the center.
And it's difficult for him because sometimes you've got people right over you, and as soon as you snap it, trying to get your hands up and block them, you can be a little bit late getting it done.
They'll come up now on a 2nd and long after the hold. They'll run with Thompson. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. And now we're going to get a timeout defensively. So another stop, 1:50 left in the football game. The Redskins on 3rd down. They've converted 3 out of 5 thus far. This is 3rd and 17. Luck now to throw.
He's going to sling this deep downfield. And that's caught inside the 35. That goes as a gain of 36 on third down.
Well, partner, I'm not sure how this drive's going to end, but how about the way they flip field position there? A nice attacking play that picked up a heck of a chunk of yardage.
So the big play has them all the way down to the 30 now for first and 10. They'll run it here with Pirine. Eventually wrangled down before reaching the 20, but a strong run. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3. Good gain there on first down. It keeps him in a running situation, probably.
They did everything right on that play, didn't they? They got the leverage up front. Good blocking. Nice hole for him. Ends up picking up nice yardage. Stays in bounds to keep the clock rolling. They are in charge of this scenario right now. They want to stay that way.
And not in any rush offensively. So they come up on 2nd down. If they can get another run like we just saw, would likely put an end to this thing. Down to a knee here. The defense still with a couple of timeouts. We'll see if they want to use them. Charles, I think when the schedule comes out, all teams, no matter where they're predicted to finish, talk about protecting your home turf. They were able to do that here in this one.
Similar to a tennis match, right? Not letting them break your serve. That way you hold on to it. They got it done, and they feel very good about that victory.
So for the Redskins, the win here means it'll be a 7-1 first half of the season. And they'll be able to enjoy this one through the bye week before they get back at it again. Meanwhile, for Philadelphia, they drop back to 500 now at 4 up and 4 down. And they'll take this loss into the bye as they'll be back in action in week 10. So that'll just about do it for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, log on to easports.com. It's a win for the Redskins as we say so long from FedEx Field.
Gang. I make a special cake, fill up a stash, okay? I'm in my bag, okay? Don't make me mad, okay? She got attached, okay? She made a match, okay? I spent the stack, okay? Dump her tracks, okay? I'm in a black, okay? I drink on, okay? I got a sack, okay? I can't relax, okay? I'm paranoid, okay? I skip some friends, okay? Shot when I land, okay? I'm in Japan, okay? I play with bands, okay? And had the man, okay? Exotic, okay? And Saran, okay? Told my little monster, go slide through there, okay? No torso, fit face, nobody safe, okay?
That's the realest time. talk.
Told you I'm the best.
Me.
I got special clothes.
Style.
Diamonds on my chest. Light up in the dark.
Whoa.
Counting up a check.
Right now.
I'm
right now.
This the way we bomb.
Free break gun. Play hate.
Ride with a boys on skate. Cranberry rave. I took him without a trace.
Whoa.
I concentrate. Don't make me blank, okay?
Okay.
I get in that zone and mode for real. I broke the bank, okay?
Big bag.
All blue hunters, them Buffalo Bills.
I work too hard, okay? The job, okay? It's raw, okay? What you saw, okay? Can't witness shots, okay? They get you, okay? Ain't got no laws, okay? Okay.
Come take this, okay? A star, okay? Break down the, okay? The car, okay? Go yard to bag, okay? Three-story pad, okay? Run through some cash, okay? I got that bad, okay?
I'm on this, okay? I'm on the flight, okay? I'm on G6, okay? Forever lit, okay? Okay, I like the trick, okay? Okay, my blood, okay? I make a splash, okay? Fill up a stash, okay? I'm in my bag, okay? Don't make me mad, okay? She got attached, okay? She made a match, okay? Double tracks, okay. I'm in no black, okay. I drink on, okay. Got a sack, okay. Can't relax, okay. I'm paranoid, okay. I'm schizophrenic, okay. Shot when I land, okay. I'm in Japan, okay.
Hey. Ay, I ain't folding under pressure, I ain't switching for no. I ain't talking to no cop and I ain't telling on my bros. Ain't no but don't push me, fingers itching on that. Plotting on my come up, gotta watch they at my nose. Long nights I just to hit the studio. Now I'm eating steak and shrimp, I ain't eating sloppy joe. Looking to the mirror, flexing now it in his glow. Bust off like a welcome to the rodeo. Shorty wanna me cousin wearing gold. I came up and made it happen, now it's by the stove. Big inside this case is once. Do me dirty, I'ma find you, lay out on the flow. 19 with a I got rich by myself. Rather do this alone, I wasn't asking for no help. They keep asking how I'm winning with the card that I was dealt. Boy, I work hard for the seat and I ain't buckling my belt. Call my brother on the phone, he said, broski, you a star. I said, brother, hold it down, soon we'll all be living large. And it's crazy how last year was out my garage. Now I'm in a good position for this life, can't sabotage. I ain't folding under pressure, I ain't switching for no. I ain't talking to no cop and I ain't telling on my bros. Ain't no but don't push me, fingers itching on that. Plotting on my come up, gotta watch they at my nose. Long nights I just to hit the studio. Now I'm eating steak and shrimp, I ain't eating sloppy joe. Looking to the mirror, flexing now it in his glow. Bust off like a welcome to the rodeo. I got tattoos on my face, I use that as motivation. I can never get a job, so for my dream I'm dedicated. For a second lost myself, I was too busy getting busy. Now they see me out in public and be knowing what my name is. All these rappers want the clout and the life of being famous. I just wanna be stable, tell my family we made it. I was coming for my spot, a young had to be patient. Now I'm running up, these bands can hit the island for vacation. I've been know my haters, you could say I'm constipated. 5 racks on his fit just to stunt while I'm in Vegas. For my body, shout out to my Caleb. Gang. Young got the cake up, now they wanna date us. I ain't folding under pressure, I ain't switching for no. I ain't talking to no cop and I ain't telling on my bros. Ain't no but don't push me, fingers itching on that. Plotting on my come up, gotta watch they at my nose. Long nights I just to hit the studio. Now I'm eating steak and shrimp, I ain't eating sloppy joe. Looking to the mirror, flexing now it in his glow. Bust off like a welcome to the rodeo.